Hi, this is Aaron with Walls Music and Sound. Today I just wanted to review my new audio interface. I got a Presonus Studio 1810C. I wanted to replace my interface that I've had for a really long time, which was the Focusrite Saffire Pro 24 DSP with VRM. This was a real workhorse. It did a lot of tracks for me. It wasn't without problems. I would say software-wise, the software mixer was very confusing. The routing was very strange, but powerful. It did have onboard effects, which was pretty cool, with no latency. But the big problem was, and the reason I replaced it, was that it's not really supported by Windows 10 anymore. And yes, I'm a Windows person. Sorry to all you Apple people. I like Apples too. In any event, I decided to switch over to something with similar ability, to this guy here. So I use it mainly for voice recording, voiceovers, single instrument, and also my keyboard. And it does all of that. And I don't have to use these crazy converters anymore that I had to buy for the Saffire, because that was a FireWire device. And this one is a Thunderbolt device, which is awesome. So it just goes right into my USB hub. So a little bit about the front of this guy, what I have going on. I have my mic going into one. I have two is empty for now. Three and four are my keyboard, which is here. My Roland Phantom 88, which I love very much. In the back, there's MIDI cables, power, and the USB input, output. And then we have some nice mixing controls here for channels, 1, 2, 3, 4. Two headphone mixes, which I really like, and then attenuation, which is pretty cool. A little bit about the software. At first, it was also a little bit confusing, but I think it's simpler to learn than the Focusrite, and it seems to be doing everything I need. So you first get this guy, the Universal Control, where you can change sample rate and the clock source and all of that. Loopback, it does have loopback, which is cool if you want to record something playing from YouTube or something like that without using cables. I don't think all of the Presonus boxes have that ability, so I'm not sure which model it starts at, but that's kind of cool. And then the other window you get is the mixer window, this guy here. So the mixer window, you can see the signal there. Let's see, what did I have to do? For some reason, I can't monitor myself until I mute and unmute myself every time I start the computer. I don't know what that's about. I also heard some weird crackly noises coming out of channel 4 when I first got this box. But that went away when I plugged my keyboard into it, so I haven't unplugged it. I'm not sure if that's still going on. That was disconcerting. What else to say about this guy? I'm still learning it, but you can have multiple mixes, which is really cool. I'm not using that yet. Yeah, it's a solid device. I like it. So far so good. We'll see. Maybe I'll do another review after I've used it for a little while. But yeah, if you're looking for something to replace an old dinosaur like this guy, or a FireWire device that isn't really modern or supported anymore, I do recommend Presonus so far. This is that guy again. It's pretty much the same size. It's a little bit longer. Pretty much the same ability. I didn't really use the VRM very much, the virtual reference monitoring. I tried it. It's so that you can mix, apparently, you know, via headphones and make it sound like you're not using headphones, because, you know, it's not easy to mix on headphones as far as, like, volume control, especially. It's good to, like, edit voiceovers and that kind of thing, but not, like, master or mix. But I don't really do that anyway. I just play it over my monitors. So I did use the reverb, but I actually have my mic going into an external mixer now that I have reverb and stuff on, so I can use that. So that's just a little review for you. I hope you enjoyed it. It's my first review, so hopefully they'll get a little bit less wordy. All right, thanks a lot. Make sure to subscribe, share, all of that, and let me know in the comments what you think of Focusrite versus Presonus, if you have any tips for Presonus devices or something else that you use or like. Thanks a lot.